Hello, hi, and namaste to all my viewers. So how are you doing out there? So today it's me, your regular subject teacher, Sudeep Limbukhim. So today we will discuss about the transformation of active voice to passive voice in case of past tense and future tense. On our previous video, we have already talked about the transformation of sentences from active voice to passive voice in case of present tense. So if you are the first viewer, then please do watch our first video related to voice as well.
Okay, the next thing that we are going to learn today is about the transformation of active voice to passive voice in case of past tense. Okay, we already know there are four structures related to past tense. Okay, the first one we are going to learn is about simple past tense. Okay, we already know the structure of simple past tense. Okay, its structure is subject plus verb 2 plus object. Okay, so while changing this structure into passive voice, okay, normally some rules are same, little bit change, okay, in case of simple past tense. Okay, so let's see. So while you change this structure into passive voice, so subject into object, object into subject, it is as usual like we have read before. Okay, so now here what we have to keep in mind is that this verb 2 will be changed into was, were plus verb 3 plus by. Okay, so this one is little bit different. In case of simple present tense, what we have done before, we have changed verb 1 or verb 5 into is, am, are plus verb 3. So now here in verb 2, we need to change this verb 2 into was, were plus verb 3. So only that is the difference. Okay, so now let's find out some examples. So Miss Rai wrote a poem. So here Miss Rai is used as subject, wrote is verb 2, a poem is used as an object. Okay, so now while changing this sentence into passive voice, okay, here a poem is object, so now we have to make this object into subject. Okay, so a poem, and then you have to see a poem is singular, and singular takes was, not were. Okay, so that's why we have to keep was here. A poem was. So what is the verb 3 of wrote? The verb 3 of wrote is written. Okay, so then a poem was written by Miss Rai. Miss Rai, same. If person's name is given, then you don't have to change. Okay, you have to write same as it is. Okay, now let's see the second one example. So someone stole my copies. Okay, we have already done too many examples related to present tense. Okay, but I think we haven't done example of someone, no one, somebody, everybody. Okay, so in case of someone, no one, somebody, everybody, or people, we don't have to use by. Okay, we don't have to use by plus subject. Okay, for example, like someone stole my copies. So my copies is used as an object. So while changing this into subject, then we have to copy the same, my copies. Okay, my copies is plural, so that's why it takes were, not was. Okay, so my copies were. What is the verb 2 of stole? What is the verb 3 of stole? The verb 3 of stole is stolen. Okay, my copies were stolen. Okay, according to the rule, we have to keep by plus subject, but here this one is the exception case. Okay, so here subject is used as someone, no one, somebody, everybody, people. So we don't have to keep by plus subject because those kind of subjects are used. Okay, so if someone, no one, somebody, everybody, people, so those kind of subjects are used, then you don't have to keep by plus subject. Okay, so this one is the exception case while changing transactive voice to passive voice. Okay, now we are going to learn about past continuous tense. Okay, how we change this past continuous structure into passive voice. So as you know, the structure of past continuous tense, okay, subject plus was, were plus, before plus, object. So when we are changing this structure into passive voice, okay, so like before, subject will be object, then object will be subject. Okay, here, sorry, I left. No. Okay, so now, object into subject, subject into object. And then was where same, okay. And if buffer is used, so buffer is changed into being plus buff 3, okay. So you have to remember if buffer ing is used, then you have to keep being, being plus buff 3, okay. So now let's see some examples. He was painting a picture. So here he is used as subject, a picture is used as an object, okay. So and according to our rule, we have to change subject into object, object into subject. So we have to use a picture as subject, a picture, okay, and then we have to use was or were. So a picture is singular and singular text, was not were, okay. So your sentence will be a picture was, and then you have to use being, being, okay. A picture was being. And then we have to use buff 3. So what is the buff 3 of painting? The buff 3 of painting is painted. Then by plus subject. So a picture was being painted by him. Okay. While using he as an object, then we have to change he into him. Okay. So likewise, let's see another example. They were buying flowers. So you can see here, they is used as subject. Flowers is used as an object. So flowers, writing same while using as subject. Flowers was or were. So flowers, it is plural, and plural takes were, not was. So flowers were, and then being, being. Flowers were being. Then we have to use buff 3. So what is the buff 3 of buying? But flowers were being, but by. So while changing they into object, we have to change they into they. Okay, so your final structure or sentence will be flowers were being bought by they. So in this way, you can change the structure of past continuous tense into passive voice easily. So we have learned already the two structures related to past tense changing into passive voice. So now we are going to learn next structure. So that is the past perfect tense. As you know, the structure of past perfect tense, subject plus had plus buff 3 plus object. So while changing this structure into passive voice, okay, like before, subject becomes object, object become subjects, okay, and then had plus buff 3 will be changed into had been plus buff 3, okay. You should remember that if buff 3 is used in sentence, then we have to change, we have to use been, b-e-e-n, been plus buff 3, okay. So if you keep in mind that thing, then you will feel much more easy, okay. So now let's see some examples. Sita had done homework. So here Sita is used as subject, homework is used as an object, okay. So while transforming this sentence or structure into passive voice, so we have to write same homework, okay, as subject, subject, sorry, homework had, then you have to keep been, had been, homework had been buff 3. What is the buff 3 of done? It's same, okay. So homework had been done by, and then Sita, you have to keep it same, by Sita, okay. No need to change if person's name is given as subject in structure, okay. Similarly, let's see next example. I had kept my promise. So here I is used as subject, my promise is used as an object, okay, and you can see the structure had plus buff 3, had kept, okay. So while changing this sentence into passive voice, okay, so my promise, okay, it is used same as subject, and then had been, my promise had been, and bhav 3. What is the bhav 3 of kept? Okay, kept itself is bhav 3. So my promise had been kept by, and then when we have to write I as an object, then we have to change this I into me. Okay, so your final answer will be my promise had been kept by me. Okay, so in this way you can change the structure of active voice into passive voice related to past tense. So now we are going to read about the transformation of active voice to passive voice in case of future tense. Okay, so my dear students, next we are going to read about the transformation of active voice to passive voice in case of simple future tense. Okay, so this one is too much easier as we have already learned about present and past. Okay, so it is also a little bit similar. So as we know, the structure of simple future tense as subject plus will or shall plus one plus object. So while transforming this sentence or structure into passive voice, then as before, subject will be object, object will be subject, and then will or shall plus bhav 1 will be changed into will shall plus be plus bhav 3 plus by. Okay, so let's do some examples. So he will teach me. So here he is used as subject, me is used as an object. Okay, and according to our rule, when we use me as object, then you have to change me into I. Okay, I, and then will or shall, we have to choose anyone. Okay, but most of the students are nowadays we prefer will than shall. Okay, I will, then we have to keep be plus bhav 3. I will be, then what is the bhav 3 of teach? Okay, it's bhav 3 is taught, so I will be taught by him. So he is changed into him while using as an object. Okay, similarly in next example, okay, you can see here they will watch TV. So they is used as subject, TV is used as an object. So while using TV as an subject, then we have to write same as it is. So TV, then will or shall, okay, we have to choose anyone, but I prefer will. So TV will be, then what is the bhav 3 of watch? The bhav 3 of watch is watched. TV will be watched, and then you have to use by, and they will be changed into them while using as an object. Okay, so in this way your final answer will be TV will be watched by them. Okay, so in this way you can solve the questions related to simple future tense while changing from active voice to passive voice. So now we are going to learn about the final structure related to transformation of active voice to passive voice, and this structure is of future perfect tense. Okay, as you know, the structure of future perfect tense, subject plus will shall plus have plus bhav 3 plus object. Okay, and while changing this structure into passive voice, okay, subject will be object, object will be subject, and then you have to keep will or shall plus have same, and bhav 3 will be changed into been plus bhav 3. Okay, so now let's look at an example. Hari will have written a letter. Okay, here Hari is used as subject, a letter is used as an object. Okay, so now let's change this sentence into passive voice. Okay, so while using this a letter as subject, okay, it will be as it is. A letter will have, then been, we have to use a letter will have been written. What is the bhav 3 of written? Written is itself bhav 3. Okay, a letter will have been written by, and then subject, which one is subject here? Hari. Okay, a letter will have been written by. So in this way we can change future perfect tense structure into passive voice. Okay, so this is all about the transformation of active voice to passive voice related to the general or simple sentences from present tense to future tense. I hope this video will be much more beneficial to all the students who are getting trouble related to this chapter. Okay, and after watching this video, if you have any kinds of questions or any kind of suggestion, please let me know about it. I will try to make a video about those questions as well. Okay, and thanks for watching.